We're trying to find the best plan to serve as many youth as we can.
And they may need to as school districts roll out plans for the fall semester. Many kids will likely spend a lot of time at home. They'll still be in virtual classrooms, but it's hard to replace what face-to-face interaction can do. And that's where some after-school programs come in. WCI3's Courtney Bunting is live in our newsroom. And Courtney, won't they just run into the same limitations?
Well, Jennifer, not necessarily. Don Moyer Boys and Girls Club has a lot fewer kids at one time, and they aren't there for quite as long as a regular school day might hold them. They feel they're a great option for kids who need those in-person interactions.
What youth do when they're out of school time is the most important times because that's where the least amount of supervision typically occurs.
We all know this fall is going to look different than years past, and some are concerned about how the changes will affect kids. That's where after-school programs are trying to help. Don Moyer Boys and Girls Club is working to bring some of that structured time back.
These are challenging times. You have to be very creative, and things are changing on the regular, so you have to be fluid with your plans.
School district leaders are still coming up with answers. In Champaign, most students will start out virtually. Only those considered higher risk will be doing in-person learning.
As this in-person unfolds over the next several weeks, if space becomes available and we find that there's some families who are reaching out to say this is a real hardship, we certainly can revisit, you know, the number of students that we can serve in person.
Don Moyer leaders are also making sure their club is a safe place for kids who do come. They're taking temperatures and sanitizing regularly. We're also limiting to 80 kids at once, but are only seeing around 65 at once this summer. On top of being a good place for kids to learn and interact, they also want them to enjoy themselves.
If we can provide opportunity for a kid to just be a kid for an hour, we believe that that's a great opportunity for youth and families in our community.
Don Moyer is still finalizing their schedule for this upcoming fall. They're looking into possibly expanding their hours as well. But they say they're waiting to hear what each school district decides. Live in the newsroom, Courtney Bunting, WCIA 3, your local news leader.
Yeah, everybody waiting for that. All right, Courtney, thank you.